Blackstone presents Soul of the Hurricane, The Perfect Storm and an Accidental Sailor by Nelson Simone. This book is read by Nelson Simone. For Mommy and Salim and Nick and Kathleen. In memory of Yvonne Mitchum Ayoroa, 1944 to 2021, Bob Thomason, 1927 to 2020, Thelma Davis, 1940 to 2020. Hurricane Alma, year 1966, Category 3, highest sustained wind, 125 miles per hour. My first hurricane was the year I was 7. My parents had been to Florida the year before with just my brother Rob to see relatives visiting from Bolivia, and they wanted to take me because Miami looked beautiful, as my mother put it. So the four of us, Mommy, Poppy, Rob, and I, packed our car and set off from our house in Adelphi, Maryland, made a quick loop halfway around the Beltway, and began the straight shot down I-95, 1,065 miles to Miami Beach. It must have been a delicate time for our young family, trying, I suppose, to become more of a family. My parents had come to this country in 1961, bringing my grandfather to the D.C. area for treatment at Walter Reed, the military hospital. Papi, trying to establish his own medical residency, was essentially living at Prince George's County Hospital, while my mother cared for her father in the tiny apartment the three of them shared. They had left my brother and me in La Paz with our grandmother, where we lived apart from them for almost a year. One day, our grandmother told us we were going to Washington, that sing-song place that had become a fairy tale kingdom to me, the faraway land where my parents lived. Suddenly, we were on a plane, Rob and I crying the whole way, from La Paz to Miami, then on to Washington National Airport. And then we were getting off in a place that was hot and muggy and strange. And nowhere did we see the aunties and uncles, cousins and nannies who populated the world we knew. That was over. I clung to my abuela as these two smiling, vaguely familiar people approached, their arms reaching for me. "When you first saw me, you weren't sure who I was," my mother would later say. "Your abuela was the mother you knew." I don't believe we planned to stay forever, but time passed and we just never left. Soon the family pooled together enough money to buy the little house on Kirsten Street that would be our home for the next several years. In 1966, still struggling financially but feeling more settled, Mommy and Poppy must have thought that our first family vacation would be just the thing. As Mommy remembered it, "We just decided to drive to Miami Beach. We didn't know the names of hotels or prices of hotels. We didn't have that much money. I went into this hotel. I asked how much it would cost for us to stay. We were only going to be there a few days. And they gave me a price for a room with a kitchenette that would be sufficient for the four of us, and we could even make breakfast there if we wanted to." The next day, we came downstairs ready for a day at the beach, only to find the staff boarding up the hotel windows. "A hurricane was coming," they said, and we had to leave. I wasn't sure what a hurricane was, but this didn't seem the right time to ask. The beach was empty, and the police were directing a long line of cars away from the hotel. Our vacation, it seemed, was over. Poppy decided we would drive straight home. We started out. Looking out the back of the car, I could see dark, swirly clouds in the distance, and everything around us had a strange gray tint. The air had that quality it does just before a storm, the feeling that something is about to happen. I later learned this is because of the falling pressure that accompanies a hurricane. Inside the car, everything felt right. My father was at the wheel, my mother beside him. Rob and I knelt on the back seat looking back at where we had been, waiting. When I remember this day, I picture my dear mother, a woman who has lived so much of her life with a heavy heart, for whom happiness has always seemed as far off as heat lightning in the distance. I see her in this moment, a young woman of 26, not so far past her own childhood. alone with her two boys and her husband, laughing. She seems to be enjoying our unexpected adventure. She is oblivious to the danger. I had never heard of a hurricane, Mommy told me later, much less seen one. In Bolivia, we lived in little towns with a river or a pond, so we had nothing to compare it to. In my mind, she is happy. Soon the rain began. With every mile we drove, the rain got harder, the skies darker. My father drove slower and slower until you could have trotted beside us.
Rob and I were. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.